am going to read you a couple of poems that I have saved recently on my Pinterest. I have a whole Pinterest board full of poems, like honestly so many. And I am just going to read you a couple that I have been resonating with lately. So, yeah. I hope you find what you're looking for out there. I hope you find the kind of happiness that exists on your own terms. I hope you truly take the time to figure out what moves you, what encourages your soul, what you deeply crave from life. And I hope you have the courage to chase that. I hope you have the courage to believe that you are deserving of everything you desire, that you are capable and worthy of curating the kind of life for yourself that sparks something within you. You have a fire inside of you. I hope you never let convenience or comfort or the easiness of standing still put it out. I hope you show the world what you can do with all of the passion inside you. I hope you find the kind of love that makes you a softer person, the kind of love that makes you want to be a better man or woman, the kind of love that believes in you and supports you, that stands by your side. I hope you find someone who quickly becomes your favorite thing, someone who makes the fall less fearful. Someone, my dog is barking, I'm so sorry. Someone who makes the fall less fearful. Someone you can't help but choose every single day. I hope you find someone who shows you just how deeply you can feel, just how deeply you can love. I hope you find someone real, because nothing is more beautiful than loving someone who loves you back. Nothing is more beautiful than loving someone who builds you a home in their heart. Next one. Good things, number 3. Big old trees, the ones that look like they've lived through all the hardships in life, yet they're still standing there stronger than ever. People who just accept you. Space, for always putting our problems in perspective. Water and freshly squeezed juice. Being able to hear and or feel someone else's heartbeat. Stardust and the moon. Candy that crackles and pops in your mouth. Swings, lamps, postcards, the human body. Flowers growing in the cracks of pavements. Lying on the floor with the music turned up to maximum volume. Photo booths, sun-kissed skin. People who make you want to live forever because this lifetime just might not be enough. Collages, standing naked in front of a mirror and being okay with your body despite all of your flaws. Today, tomorrow, and now. Look, I just wanted to have a little bit of a chit chat because I feel like my recent vlogs, I haven't really been speaking directly to the camera like I usually would. I think I'm taking like a different sort of creative approach to my vlogs. I want to show you my life, but in a way of storytelling. You know what I mean? I want to show you all the aspects of who I am, but through the lens of how I see my life. And I also want to add aspects of creativity and sort of sparks of my imagination into my storytelling. I've been just taking this wave of my life with such an open heart because it's really teaching me how to be a better person and how to see the world through a different type of lens that I have ever seen it before. Because I'm learning to see people for obviously who they really truly are, and I think that I've always been someone who chooses to see someone's good side even when they choose to show me their bad side. And that isn't necessarily a bad thing, but I think that sometimes that can be a downfall of mine because I choose to see the good in people when they choose to show me the bad. And that is the biggest message in that. People are choosing to show me the bad parts of them because they think that I'm only deserving of that energy. I think it's just one of those things with growing up, you sort of learn to deal with things and not deal with things. And the sort of people you are around and choose to involve yourself with very much dictate almost how you behave as a person and what you perceive, you know what I mean? And I'm just learning to sort of not allow people to walk over me like I used to, and really learning to let people go when I know that they're not deserving of me, because there's no point of letting people reoccur and come back into my life that haven't changed, because they're just going to keep doing the same thing over and over. And it sounds harsh, and I know that, and it's something I'm trying to learn, because I feel like I continuously let people back when they haven't learned the lesson of why they left my life in the first place. And that's okay for them, and honestly, everyone has their own journey, and everyone's got their own things that they're learning and how they see the world. But this is my journey, this is my story. I just want to be around people who love me as much as I love them, and are deserving of my love, and I'm deserving of theirs, you know, vice versa. Because I think that we all deserve to be around people that honor and accept our greatness and our flaws, because that's the biggest thing. Someone who can see you for who you truly are and still love you is something so beautiful and profound, and something that you is so rare. Like, I just, you know, and I know I'm rambling now, but we are going to Motley Crue. I am so fucking excited. Honestly, like, beyond excited. I have been obsessed with Motley Crue, like, since I was about 12. So, like, 8 years. Literally forever. And Def Leppard are going to be there too. Def Leppard also slay. Not as obsessed with them as I am with Motley, but I am literally stoked. Where are we going, Dad?